Recently, I shot this image where the sky was overexposed and needs replacing. This happened even though I was using a 3-stop reverse ND grad filter to reduce its brightness. Fortunately, I spotted the problem at the time and took this second shot where I reduced the exposure by 3 stops. In today's video, I'll show you how to easily fix exposure problems like this by replacing the sky using Affinity Photo. I'm starting with both of the images open in Affinity Photo. My first step is to copy the dark image onto the light image as a new layer. I can do this by right-clicking on the background layer with my mouse, then selecting Copy from the pop-up menu. I'll then switch to editing the overexposed image, where I can right-click using my mouse. In the pop-up menu, I'll select the option to paste the image I copied as a new layer. I now have both images open in the same Affinity Photo document as separate layers. When I'm making a repair like this, I prefer to have the image with the darker sky as the top layer of the two. Next, I'll rename the two layers to be sky and ground so that I can quickly see what each is used for. Now I'll add a layer mask to the sky layer, which I'll use to reveal just the sky from the darker image. To do this, select the sky layer by clicking with the mouse. Then click the mask layer icon at the bottom of the Layers Studio panel. When the new mask appears, I'll click it using my mouse to make sure it's selected. Now I can invert the mask by pressing Command and I on my keyboard, which is Control and I if you're using a Windows PC. You can see here that this has turned the mask black, which completely hides the dark sky layer. Now all we can see is the lighter ground layer with the well-exposed heather and rocks. The next step is to paint in the sky from the darker layer to replace the overexposed sky. We do this by painting with white on the layer mask using the paintbrush tool. The trick to replacing the sky is to blend the two images together so they appear natural. This means we need to avoid hard edges between the sky and ground and any halos it could produce. We can achieve this by painting through a selection created using the lightest pixels in the image. Now we have a few methods we could use to select the light areas of the image. The one that I find easiest and which works with most images is to load one of the color channels from the ground layer. When I click the Channel Studio panel, you can see the composite red, green and blue color channels in the image. If I click one of these channels, you can see that it's displayed as a black and white image. What I want to find is a channel that separates the sky from the hillside, but which has a soft blend between the two. If you look at the red channel here, you can see that the sky is white and the hills in the background are slightly darker. This is what we want to see. But there's another problem with this channel because some of the fields are too light. If we paint through a selection created from the red channel, we'll end up replacing the fields as well as the sky. Compare this now to the blue channel where you see the same fields are grey. This will probably make a better channel to use to make a selection to replace the sky. To use the channel, I'll right-click on it with the mouse. Then in the pop-up menu, I can click the option Load to Pixel Selection. When the channel loads, you can see the marching ants appear on the image. This shows that there's an active selection we can now use. But before continuing, I'm just going to reset the channel window so that we see the color image again rather than the blue channel. To do this, click the arrow icon to the top right of the panel. Now let's select the paintbrush tool from the tools palette on the left. To paint in the replacement sky, we want to use a soft brush to help with blending the new sky, making it look natural. I'll therefore set the hardness slider to 0%, which creates a soft edge to the brush. I'm then going to leave the flow set to 100%, but I'll reduce the opacity to about 60%. This means I'll need to make several brush strokes to paint in the sky, which also helps with the blending. Now I can paint on the layer mask using white, where I want to reveal the darker sky layer. If you find the marching ants are blocking your view, you can easily hide them in the view menu. This only hides the selection, but the selection itself remains active. Sometimes when you paint in a new replacement sky, you may want to retain some lighter areas to make the image appear more believable. To do this is simple, just don't paint over these areas of the mask as much. It can also help to reduce the opacity of the brush once you've made a couple of brush strokes. If you find that some areas are becoming too dark, switch to painting with black on the mask rather than white. You can do this by pressing X on your keyboard. When you paint over areas of a layer mask with black, it hides the darker layer, making the image lighter. We now have a reasonable blend between the ground and the new replacement sky, but we can do more to balance the exposure between the two. Now before continuing, I'm just going to clear my selection with the deselect option in the select menu. I can then add a levels adjustment to both the ground and sky layers to refine the exposure of each. To do this, I'll select the ground layer in the Layer Studio panel by clicking it. Then I'll click the adjustments icon at the bottom of the layers panel and choose levels from the menu. You can then move the black, white and gamma levels to adjust the layer's exposure. Because the levels adjustment appears above the ground layer but below the sky layer, it only affects the ground. Next, I'll select the sky layer and add a levels adjustment above that. This time when I adjust the levels, it affects all the layers below it in the layers panel. Because I only want to adjust the sky, I can click and drag the levels layer and drop it onto the sky in the studio's panel. It then reappears attached to the sky layer and only affects that layer. Now I can safely make my adjustments to the sky to improve the exposure. With the exposure balanced between the sky and ground, the image is now looking much better. Let's compare that to the original ground layer and you can see the improvement this makes. I can then finish off the image with any further adjustments I need to make. I also want to mention that there's a second method you can use to create a more accurate selection of the sky. This involves creating a luminosity mask, as I explain in this video. The technique uses a simple curves adjustment and allows you to target different areas of an image based on their brightness. I hope you found this video helpful. Thanks for watching, and I hope you'll visit again in the future.